Hello, dear friends, welcome back again. Today we are going to discuss about computer hardware, and this is the part one of the several series that will be following after this one. Some will be having practical experience and others will just do the theoretical part of it. So without wasting much time, let's get started. So the first thing is that what do we mean when we say computer hardware? What is computer hardware? We can define computer hardware, or we can say computer hardware refers to the physical parts or components of a computer, such as the monitors, mouse, keyboard, computer data storage, hard disk, system unit. In the system unit, you can find graphics cards, out card, memory card, motherboard, and other chips. And all of which are a physical object that can be touched. So when we are talking about computer hardware, we are saying that these are the physical part or component of a computer that can be seen and touched by a human being. For example, the monitor, you can touch it. For example, the hard disk, you can touch it. For example, the system unit, you can touch it and feel it. But for example, when we say about, for example, Chrome, you can't be able to touch it or be able to feel it. So you just is an application software. So when we talk about computer hardware, we mean that these are the physical object or component of a computer that can be touched and felt by a human being. And so in computer hardware, the hardware are divided into several categories, and there are five main computer or computer components, that is hardware component of our computer system. And in these five categories, we have one, computer input devices. The second one is storage devices. The other one is output devices. The fourth one is the communication devices. And finally, we have processing devices. These are devices used for entering data or instructions to the processing unit. So in other terms that we are using here is that we mean that there are several categories of computer hardware. So for example, in this category, we have seen that we have computer input devices, we have storage devices, we have output devices, we have communication devices, and we have processing devices. So the next thing is that we look at one, and we look at each and every category of these devices. And the first one is computer input devices. So in computing, an input device is a piece of equipment used to provide data and control signal to an information processing system such as a computer or information appliance. So when we are talking about input devices, these are a piece of equipment used to provide data or enter a signal into a computer system or an information system. In other terms, an input device is essentially a piece of hardware that sends data into a computer. For example, when we say an input device, for example, in this case, a mouse is used to click on the interface of a computer or the screen of a computer. When we say about keyboard, you use keyboard to enter data into the computer. When we say about scanners, we scan the hard copy papers into a soft copy that can be entered into a computer. That's why we say that input devices, these are equipment or used to provide data or a signal into an information system such as a computer. So below there we have several input devices. The one, the first one is keyboard. The second one is mouse, scanner, cameras, joystick, and microphones. There are so many other input devices, but these are just a few examples. So the next category is storage devices. So a storage device is a piece of hardware of a computer hardware used for saving, carrying, and pulling out data. It can keep and retain information in short term and long term. It can be a device inside or outside a computer. So in other terms, we are saying that a storage device is a computer hardware that can be used to save data. For example, a flash drive. You can take a flash drive, enter your data inside, and save it for future reference. It can be used to carry data. It can be used to pull out data. For example, the audio part of a computer. That is, it can be used to pull out the data that has been stored in a computer. So and also we have said below here we have said that these this information, it can retain this information in short term or long term. For example, if you know the difference between RAM and ROM, where the ROM is a read-only memory and the RAM is a random access memory. So you realize that RAM just stores data for a short while or in short term, and when electricity goes off, then the data that was stored there is lost. But for example, for ROM or read-only memory, the data is stored there for a long term. So another thing is that other terms for storage devices is storage medium or storage medium. Example include but not limited to the following, that is hard disk, that is a read-only memory. We have solid state drive, we have free access memory, that's RAM, and we have said that RAM is used for storing data for a short term. And we have CD and DVD, we have a USB flash drive. Then the third category is output devices. An output device is any piece of computer hardware or equipment which convert information into human readable form. So if you are familiar with computing, you realize that the only language or the only thing that computers understand is zeros and ones. So for example, if you enter, if you type anything on your keyboard and it is displayed on your machine, it is, first of all, it is sent to the computer in form of zeros and ones, and that one is interpreted and then displayed to your screen in human readable form. Because for you, you can't understand zeros and ones, so the computer interprets that and gives and converts that information into human readable form. So it can be text, graphics, audio, video, or any form that can be read by a human being. Some of the output devices are visual display units, that is monitors, printers, and graphic output devices, and speakers. So for example, you have an audio that you want to listen to, or you have a video that you want to listen to. As you watch the video, you can be able to see the you can be able to hear the audio from the speakers. So the fourth category is communication devices. A communication device is an hardware piece, device capable of transmitting an analog or digital signal over the telephone or other communication like wire or wireless mediums. So in other terms, we are saying that, for example, if you connect your computer into an Ethernet cable, what does that mean? An Ethernet cable is a medium of communication between your laptop or your computer to the outside, to the internet, that is the outside world. So we are saying that communication devices, these are devices used or capable of transmitting an analog or digital signal. So the examples of these communication devices can be a modem, network or network ant, that is use when you are using Ethernet cable, then Wi-Fi devices when using Wi-Fi from a router. Then the last or the fifth category is the processing device, and in this category we say processing devices are the compute the component responsible for processing of information within a computer system. So this processing devices include CPU, memory, and motherboard. So for example, every time that you enter raw data, for example, you are typing 1 + 1, you get the answer is 2. So this information, first of all, must be processed for you to get this output. And we have seen that examples of this one is CPU, memory, and motherboard. So the last thing we look at is what is a motherboard. Now this is the last piece that we look at, motherboard. The motherboard is a printed circuit board and a foundation of a computer, that is the biggest board in a computer chassis. So we are saying that motherboard is a printed circuit. If you look at the motherboard of any computer, you realize that there are so many things that are there in that motherboard, and this implies that it is a printed circuit and is a foundation of a computer, that is the biggest board in a computer cases. It allocates power and allows communication to and between the CPU, RAM, and all other computer hardwares. So basically, that is what you have been able to look at. This is the part one of it. The next part, it will be the practical part of it, where we will be able to see this component one by one, and it will be a practical. So I'll be doing it so that you can be able to see it. Thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Thank you.